A Starlink dish isn't actually a dish antenna. It's actually a flat panel with 1,000 different antennas on it. 1,280 different antenna elements.
Well, let's say you have a phased array of 4 antennas, and I'm trying to listen to some radio up here. So how do they imitate being a dish pointed at that? Let's say we have a radio coming from this guy, right? So a radio wave going to the first antenna. Same radio wave goes to the second antenna, in the same amount of time, goes just a little bit further. And when it goes to the next one, further, because these antennas are closer, so the signal overshoots. So the big trick is you delay whatever signal gets in on this antenna by this much. You delay whatever comes on this antenna by this much, on this antenna by this little bit, and this antenna you just feed it in. And once you do those delays, you can just add the 4 signals up and you end up getting a signal that's 4 times as strong because you added all 4 up, and they're added in phase because you delayed them the right amount.
So this becomes like a laser. It's such a tight beam pointed at that satellite, and they adjust it in software as the satellite goes by. They change the delays because they know which way the satellite's going. They're able to track it across the sky with this really tight beam. And any noise that's not the satellite off to the side gets destructive interference. Ultimately, though, it is diminishing returns.
So I've got my 4 antennas, but there's something else here that's broadcasting signals we don't want to listen to. Well, how do they get affected by these delayed signals being added up? Turns out the noise is added up as the signal received at each one squared, and then you take the square root of the whole thing. Turns out meaning 1 squared plus 1 squared plus 1 squared plus 1 squared, take square root, you get 2. So here's what happens. The signal you're looking for, you get 4 times as strong. The noise you're not interested in also gets increased, but it's only 2 times as strong. So your signal to noise ratio still improves by 2 to 1. So 4 antennas is typically about twice as good as 1 antenna.
1,000 times as many antennas, it's like 30 times as good as 1. You're starting to get to a lot of antennas. And at some point you just say, I want a second Starlink dish or another satellite dish from another service pointed at some other satellite. And that probably becomes an easier way to boost it if this isn't enough. And then you end up looking at something like Speedify to bond all these connections together to get you, you know, the increased throughput and reliability. Subscribe for more stories on connectivity and security.